AnyType is one of the most interesting note-taking apps on the market, and that's primarily because of something called object-first note-taking. We're going to explore that concept as well as guide you through some of the powerful features in AnyType, including security, databases, and more, in this video to help you get started with the application. Hello everyone, my name is Francesco D'Alessio and welcome to Toolfinder. We're going to explore AnyType in this video, and if you want to, you can subscribe. And as we go throughout this video, if you do enjoy it, hit the like button and comment below. It helps other people find the video and expand our channel. So some little house notes before we begin. If you want to download AnyType, you'll find it up here or down in the description below. We'll hopefully get a deal so that you can get access to more features, more benefits as part of Toolfinder. And we might also have a course that will help you to learn AnyType if I muster up some time to do it. So AnyType's a really interesting application. It's available on all desktop devices, including Linux, Mac, and Windows, and it has a Chrome extension as well. It also has an iOS and Android app in a wide variety of downloads as part of the Android version, and has a really good rating across those applications, which is rare for a fairly new application to the market, and does have speedy native apps on all of those. Today, I'll be demonstrating the Mac version, but let's dive into pricing before we move on. The free plan is obviously nothing per month, gets you 1 GB of network storage, 3 shared spaces, and 3 space members. The builder plan is priced at $99 a year, allows you access to a global name, and gives you 128 GB of network space, 2 shared spaces, 10 editors, and unlimited viewers. Obviously, this is subject to change, so do check out in the link below. There was also a co-creator plan, which is $299 every 3 years, which works out at $99.60 per year, only shaving off 30p a year if you were to go with that longer term plan, but gives you a few bonuses naturally to access more storage and things like that. This application is local first, open source, and it does come with end-to-end encryption as part of the free plan. It's designed for security to help keep your notes protected, and they have a whole policy about it on their website. So now I'd like to jump over to the laptop to dive into AnyType in a bit more detail. So here we are with AnyType, and one of the first things that you can do is go ahead and create a brand new space. Now inside of AnyType, creating a space is a workspace for all of your notes and objects and data that are stored. And you can create multiple spaces for each of the different projects for your team and personal use cases. And what's beneficial with that is you can share it with other people to collaborate in. Now, first things to explore is the object-based note-taking. An object-based note-taking in AnyType is really simple. Everything is objects. Now, it's very much like when you're going about your day. You interact with different things, whether it be a human, a meeting, a book, or whatever you like. The application will help you to structure it from the start. So, for example, in this case, I can create a recipe, and naturally, that is a recipe, meaning that gets a template that is different to it each time. So for example, when I create a recipe, the ingredients, instructions, and some other details can be added below, which means that you can add things like relations that are important to each thing. So basically think of objects as note-taking with templates, and it gives you that consistency in your note-taking to create things like meeting agendas, project plans, journals, whatever you like. Now, each of the notes or objects that you create inside of AnyType have markdown writing support, which is great for easy formatting, styling, and you can press the slash command to access a bunch of different text formatting options. You do have the ability to upload things like PDF, audio, video files, URLs, and much more, and it's quite easy to attach. But do remember that when you upload anything to AnyType, it gets passed as your storage. So anything that you upload, even to the free plan with 1 GB, it allows and contributes to your network space. Now moving on, many people like AnyType because what it does well is the graphs, backlinks, and widgets. Let me show you them briefly. So every time you use a note and you connect them up to another note, that's called a backlink. And in AnyType, that's the exact same experience. For example, if I created a human object, for Bob, which is somebody that I know, then I can backlink it to the bone soup because they introduced me to that, helping to create a relationship between a human and a recipe. And that can obviously extend much more. Now, if I go to the graph view, it's great for creating a visual map of those notes and those interconnections, and you can see how backlinks are created. You can also see things like flow, which allows you to see links to the object, and also things like PDFs and documents that are part of that. But it helps you to see a broader network of your notes and how they're connected up together. Now, in terms of getting started with backlinks, it's really easy. You can press the at mention and just mention something you've created as part of your account, and you can build that up inside of your AnyType account. Now, there's something called widget creation, which is really easy to do, but it's a great way to access important tools on the site. Think of it as your favorites bar with a little bit more power. For example, I created one called a daily planning area where I can plan my daily actions for the day. But it's great because it's got this filtering built into the widget bar, allowing you to see a real-time update of the tasks that you need to do across all of your accounts. So for example, if you create a task as part of another object, it'll all link up as part of sets, something we'll dive into a bit later on. Now, as part of all of the objects you create, you can have a layout for those pages. This is great because a layout can be different for each object you create. For example, when you create a human, it could be based on a profile. For example, with a recipe, it could be based on a set of instructions. But it's important to set these up and make these visually appealing each time you're getting going, because once you set the groundwork for them, it'll help you to create that object for future. Now, moving on to the databases, they're a little bit confusing in AnyType, but I wanted to explain what they are. There are two types of databases. There's a collection and a set. A collection is basically a database, and a set is basically a collection of object types, if that makes sense. So for example, if you just want to create a series of all of the different projects you're working on, then you can create a set. And the set is great to basically just focus on an object type, which narrows down your options. So for example, in this case, I can see all of the tasks I need to do across all of my account, which allows me to add the object type task. Then you can build filters or even tabs, for example, narrowing down filters. So for example, today scheduled allows me to see what's coming up based on a set defined criteria of filters, with the due date after today and done is unchecked, allowing me to see what I need to do. And collections are much more focused towards being very generalistic. So they can be absolutely anything. You can still use the filtering to narrow down what sorting you have and things like that. But largely, it's much more open plan than sets are. Sets are very much designed around the concept of object types. With databases, you can use these in a wide variety of ways, for content calendars, for CRM templates, for task management. And it's got quite an extensive set of views for an application like this. It's got grid view, gallery, list, Kanban, calendar, and graph, with a few abilities like properties, filters, and sorting, but not extensive abilities like you find in apps like Notion. But to be honest, it's pretty good for getting going. So in terms of how the syncing works, it's pretty impressive. It always shows a green mark on the top left-hand side to show that it's locally stored on your device. And it shows when these are synced and how they're synced as well. And it works across all of the devices that you have, as long as you're signed into the application and to your network, which is great. So for example, the iOS application gives you full functionality on the go to create, edit, and organize your notes. And it is a really intuitive experience that is highly rated on the App Store. All of these have great offline capabilities thanks to the local first focus, and they're all protected by end-to-end secured notes, which is very helpful. So a lot of people might be scratching their heads at the end of this video asking, should I move to AnyType, or is AnyType a suitable application for me? Well, AnyType is really much, very much like Obsidian, a secure note-taking application that focuses on local first storage. It's got a few power features, the developers are releasing every single month, and the applications are second to none. They're very well designed and brilliant and easy to use. The application is and does take a little bit of time to get used to, but if you're open to the concept of object-based note-taking, then it might be something you're interested in. The application has a few quirks in terms of how it's set up with collections and sets, but once you get your head around it, it's actually not too difficult to get things rolling. The application also contributes to things like tasks and projects. So personal planning and management can be included inside of AnyType, which is quite helpful. Something that other applications might limit you to in terms of their structure of creating a task and a project. So AnyType is a really interesting application if you're looking for planning and also to be able to create a structure out of your PKM-like application. It's a really interesting bet with a solid set of security features and a real mission to try and be a security-focused application with good quality features. So a really interesting application if you're out there looking for something in the PKM space that does a little bit more than some of the other options. So thank you very much for stopping by. If you actually like this video, I would love to see that in the comments below. It helps other people to discover the video and helps us to grow our network. We'll try and secure a deal on AnyType if you're interested in it, and you'll find those links below. As I said, I'll try and work on a course and let's see whether it'll help you to learn AnyType in more detail. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio.